It's been a while since I last unboxed or featured the Vans sneaker here on the vlog, but that changes today. We have with us the Vans Varix Waffle Cup, Vans' first lifestyle sneaker featuring the Waffle Cup technology, which is inspired by the 2000 skate culture. Guys, welcome to the vlog. My name is Carlo. This is where we talk about sneakers, life, and tech. And today is another sneaker unboxing. If you guys haven't subscribed to the channel yet, please make sure that you do so because we are about to announce the mechanics for our raffle for the Samsung Galaxy J4 Plus. Make sure that you're subscribed, make sure that you hit the notification bell, and make sure that you follow me on Instagram so you can be part of the pool when we do the raffle. This sneaker was special because it's the first Van sneaker, in my opinion, that didn't look like a Van sneakers. Because there is a certain type of design for Vans, and you see it with a lot of the sneakers and shoes that they have. This one is like a breakout in terms of design and in terms of styling, which is pretty good because it shows that Vans is willing to go out of their, you know, comfort zone to be able to innovate. So this sneaker comes in your typical brown and red Vans box with Vans off the wall printed at the top with multiple Vans logos along the sides of the box, and you have the information of the sneaker here on the side as well. I did get it true to size, so this is the Turtle Dove true W something colorway of the Varix Waffle Cup, and the SRP is 6,998 pesos, a little over $130. So let's get to the unboxing. So very straightforward, you just pop it open, you have the tissue paper, and then you have the shoe itself, and OMG! This one is straight up fire. And just as you guys can see while I am holding it in my hand, it really doesn't look like your typical Van sneaker. It is not just one color. It is not like checkered. It actually reminds me a lot of the chunky dad shoes that you see today, which have been popularized heavily, of course, by Adidas and Nike. Now let's talk about the sneaker. So it has multiple layers and a lot of textures, which is something that I really love. I've been talking about that a lot on this vlog, wherein I love multi-dimensional, multifaceted sneakers. So let's talk about the material. So first up, for the toe box, you have this leather toe box over here, but they even made it a little bit better because there is a leather lining here just at the top, which also stretches here in the middle with the stitching. The stitching reminds me a lot of the deconstructed stitching style because it is loud and it is exposed. Then you have the mesh toe box. So that's the part where you guys see here in the middle, as well as here along the lateral and the medial side, which gives it flexibility and breathability. You then see the suede material also here along the sides, these two little patches over here, as well as here in the middle of the laces. Apart from that, you have leather detailing again on the lateral and the medial side of the sneaker. That brown tan patch that you guys see over here. We also have leather here along the collar of the sneaker. That's the light blue color that you see over here. You have the Vans branding, which is very minimal and small, just in a tag at the side of the sneaker. You also have the Vans logo here at the back, just above this suede orange patch here at the bottom. If you go to the midsole and the outsole, you have the Vans Waffle Cup technology, and to help even more with the comfort, you have the Vans Ultra Cush insole over here, or Ultra Cush technology, which definitely helps a lot with the comfort and overall feel of the shoe. Now, this is one of the louder colorways available here in the Philippines. I was actually able to buy this from Cul-de-Sac over at Podium, but you should be able to find it available also at Akimbo. They have a store over at Uptown Mall BGC. If you are looking for more subdued or subtle colors, there is a black version of this, which is more easy to wear and super versatile. And there is also a white and gum sole version as well, which you can rock. This one is the loudest colorway that I saw, and that's the reason why I picked it up, just in time for summer here in the Philippines. How is this on feet? I've been able to wear it now for a little over a day, and I can tell you that it's one of the more comfortable Van sneakers out there that doesn't need as much break-in as you would normally need for a Vans pair of kicks. Now, it's still not the most comfortable sneaker I've ever had, and maybe that's because I'm a bit spoiled with the Boost technology, of course, of Adidas, or the React technology of Nike, or the Hover technology of Under Armour, all of which I regularly wear and rock, mainly because I just love comfort more than anything else. But it doesn't really take away anything a lot from this shoe, because at the end of the day, you have a very unique design, you have a very unique style, and it does deliver great cushioning and everyday wear. So do I recommend the Vans Varix Waffle Cup? The answer is, yeah, it's a nice shoe. It's a nice all-around sneaker with multiple layers, multiple textures, great comfort and cushioning. At the same time, the price point is still pretty competitive and reasonable. And I would like to think in a world that that's currently dominated by Nike Flyknits and Reacts and Pure Boosts and Ultra Boosts, this is a nice sneaker to wear that will allow you to stand out, be hype, and at the same time be unique and not necessarily you spending a ridiculous amount of money just to be able to afford nicely designed and well-built sneakers. And that actually wraps up our unboxing and on-feet review of the Vans Varix Waffle Cup. Let me know what you guys think of this sneaker in the comment section down below. Should I do more reviews of Vans sneakers? Let me know. I'd love to hear from you guys. Just let yourselves be heard in the comment section. That's actually it for the vlog. I hope you guys are having a great weekend. Peace. God bless. What's up? Boom.